Good morning, children. This is your Vanuja teacher, and we are in the continuation of our third lesson, Rain, where does it come from? Before entering into the content, just I want to recapitulate the yesterday's topics, what we have discussed. We have discussed how to predict the weather, how our grandparents used to predict the weather, and what is meant by evaporation, what are the forms of water, what are the daily activities where the evaporation will be going on. All these we have discussed. Let us continue our lesson, Rain, where does it come from? Yes. Here I am giving you a slide, children. It is our common experience that on cold winter mornings, when we speak, we observe a smoke like vapor, like this smoke like vapor, which will be coming out of our mouth. Why it is coming and why it is not coming in summer? Did you ever experience this one in the summer, children? No. Why? Because the atmosphere will be very hot, but in the winter season the air in our surroundings will be very cold, and the air which is coming out of your mouth will be comparatively hot. That's why the air which is coming from your mouth enters into the atmosphere, it suddenly cools and it will form a very tiny droplets, and these droplets concentrated in a limited area appear like smoke or a small cloud near our mouth. Not only this one, in sometimes in the month of December and January, you may experience some fog when you go for the walk, in the morning walk. And also you will be able to find a few drops of water on the grass also. That one nothing but you will be calling it as a dew. See this slide, children? This is like this, you will be getting it. Is it or not? Then this is called as a dew, children. And why these are all are happening, why this dew is forming, why the cloud like structure will be there when you speak in the winter season, what are the reasons behind it? These are all the experiences which we will be having, and now we will go for the reasons, or we will go for the reason why it is happening like that. Yes, we will go with one more slide. Here I have taken a glass of cold water and I have placed it on the table. Then after some times, if you clearly observe, see small drops of water have been formed the outside of the glass, isn't it? Are you able to see, children? The water droplets are formed outside of the glass. I have taken a cold water. If I have taken a normal glass of water, you don't find like this. But if I have taken some cold water out of the fridge and if I keep it on the table for some time, then we can experience like this, small droplets of water will be there formed on the surface of the glass. The reason is the atmosphere or the air which is surrounded this glass will be hotter than the temperature which is there for the ice cubes. Surely it will be, because this ice water you will be taking out from the freezer and the temperature will be very less compared to the air which is present around the glass. And once you place this, the air which is surrounding to this glass will be suddenly cold and it will be forming a small droplets of water around the glass. Okay, did you understand, children, why we are able to have that small droplets of water around the glass? If you take a glass or if you take a water bottle also you will be experiencing in the summer season when you are coming to your school, right from the February and April, you will be bringing some cold water and you will be finding some small droplets of water around the water bottle. Is it or not? These are all due to condensation. The process of conversion of water vapor into water is said to be condensation. Here is one more example, children. Here also some ice cube water, cold chilled water I have taken and have placed it on the table, and I will be able to observe the water droplets. This is also because of the reason condensation. The process of conversion of or a change of water vapor into water is called as condensation. Then now we have got what is meant by evaporation, what is meant by condensation. Now how these clouds are formed? Our next question is how the clouds are formed and how the rain is coming. Is it or not? Yes, let us search why the clouds are coming. Okay. Yes, how do the clouds form? What is happening or what is making this cloud to form in the atmosphere? See here, children, because of the sun's heat, the surface of the water bodies, either oceans, seas, lakes or rivers, the water will be evaporated here and it will be forming the clouds. And these clouds, not only on their surfaces, from any of the ground surfaces, the water will be getting evaporated because of the sun's heat, and they will be forming the clouds. And all those clouds don't stay in the same place. They will be moving depending upon the flow of wind. And once these gathering will be more, the formation of clouds, and these clouds will be more, at that time they will be forming a very big clouds. And when this a cold air touches, then they will form the small water droplets. And these tiny droplets remain floating in the air at higher levels of the atmosphere, and they appear to be like a cloud. Did you understand, children? And you can see the clouds in the kitchen also sometimes. That means a small cloud. Let us see that also. Clouds in kitchen. See here. It looks like a cloud, isn't it or not? Yes, it looks like a cloud. Why? Because here I think I have taken a vessel. Not this one. One more example I am telling for you, children, rather than this. I have taken a vessel filled with some water. And I have kept it on a stove and I am heating it. After some times, already I have covered it, the vessel, with a plate. After some times, if you remove the plate, you will be seeing the vapors will be coming out like this from the vessel. Is it or not? And even in the afternoon time, you will be taking the lunch in your school. At that time, when your mother packs the food very hot, then once you open the lid, you can see the water droplets will be coming out. That is because of the condensation. When she have packed the food, at the time it is very hot. And these water in the form of vapor, it have been stuck to the lid. And after some times, the weather also, which is around it, will become cool. And it will form a very small droplets. And it will stay there itself. Once you remove the lid from that, and you can see the water droplets all combine together and they will flow down like this. Also, in that is a way how these clouds are also getting formed. They don't form at a single place. They will be formed at different water bodies or different places, and they will start moving from one place to another place in the direction of the wind. Like this, they come together and they become laden with water vapor. When the winds bring the clouds from seas to the land, the colder air in the upper layers of the atmosphere cools the clouds. And that is the way for the beginning of the rain. Did you understand, children, how the clouds are formed? Today we have discussed about condensation and what are the different examples which are going in your life because of the reason of condensation and how these clouds are formed. Yes, tomorrow we will discuss the remaining topic. Thank you, children, and here we will go with your assignment. Write it in your book and bring it to the school when it opens. Thank you. Have a nice day.